We start the presentation in Sweden, 3,000 years ago, just to show you that ripping, the things we talk about these days, Magoi Ripper and all, it's nothing new, anything about it. They did it in many places a long time ago. Here's another one, picture from Egypt, even older, 1200 BC. Two oxen. And this is not a plow, this is actually a ripper. Then we have here the same idea of the Maresha in Ethiopia. That's today, that's during a visit of Wahara annual meeting 2 years ago. The Maresha and the tools that we saw from Sweden and Egypt, and those tools actually are the most widespread tools used still today and over the years in the past. Tools after the planting stick and the hand hoe, those are hand tools. Now the first animal drawn tool was a tool like the Maresha, and used in Latin America, in the past in Europe, in Africa still a lot, Asia still a lot. So it's the tool to talk about. And that's what we're going to do today. Talking about the Magoi Ripper, which is a tool that we use with animals to rip, and it's developed in Zambia, and we have adapted it for Burkina Faso. But the story of the Magoi Ripper actually starts in Niger. Niger is neighboring Burkina, same situation of dry soils, dry conditions of agriculture. But the soils are not very hard to work, although there's a small crust usually on top, but very thin, and if you break that, water can penetrate. But farmers actually are used to plowing as a traditional animal-drawn tool. But on those mostly sandy soils, it's a bit overdone. And when we were there working in agriculture and trying to mechanize systems and working with farmers who are plowing, we actually saw that it's not really necessary to plow those lands. And we came up with a tool which is kind of a ripper. It looked already like the Magoi Ripper today. Just a chisel tine and some small wings to keep the soil out of the furrow so that you can plant in it. And that speeds up the planting a lot. In Zambia, we saw a bit the same, although the situation is different in terms of rainfall. There's much more of it. Farmers plowing in Zambia because mainly of weeds problems, and when planting, they wanted to get first rid of the weeds and prevent them to come back when the crop is growing. But plowing has the disadvantage that you need to wait until the soil is wet enough before you can actually go deep enough to plow. And that delays the planting a lot. Here farmers even plowing way into the season. As you can see the grass there, it's a rainy season well on its way. And that's why farmers realize we need to still speed up as much as we can, and that's why farmers plant behind the plow, a system which you see in this picture, where women behind there are directly planting, seeding the maize into the furrow, every third furrow. But that really leaves a very bad crop in terms of very irregular crop, not regular in depth, because of the furrow is not regularly in depth, and also the line's not very parallel. So weeding later on with tools that farmers have there for oxen, those weeders are not easy to pass with those irregular lines. And that's why we saw, let's go for a tool that makes better furrows, and that's the ripper. Where we think, let's just make planting furrows and plant in those furrows. So it's a tool, a chisel tool, a tine. This one is the first version that we had with a pointed tine, and the wings, just as you saw on that ripper from Niger, but a bit adapted to the frames that they have in Zambia. And this is the current version of the Magoi Ripper. A beveled chisel tine of good steel and strong wings that keep the furrow open when the soil is ripped open, so that farmers have an open furrow that they can plant into it. And there's little ridges that are pushed aside along this the furrows that is then pushed back after planting, and the crop can grow. It's much faster than plowing, and farmers see as the biggest advantage that they say we can plant on time, we can plant early. And that is an important advantage, because then the crop is early in, and that's actually one of the major contributing factors to a good yield. And even to fight the weeds, because if the crop is early and fast growing, then the weeds have less chance. They can better compete with those weeds. The planting depth is regular, and the rows are evenly spaced. And then also, as farmers observed after having used the Maguire Ripper for a while, the first test farmers came back to us and said, actually, it's also very good to trap water on sloping land if you make your furrows along the contours. Now, this ripper was then introduced into the conservation farming promotion that came into being in Zambia in the late 80s, 90s. But conservation farming then was promoted with farmers using the hand hoe. So digging the planting basins by hand was the system promoted. And that's a very effective way of growing a better crop and capturing water in the furrow, in the planting basins. But it's slow, and in a way it's an inefficient system. Farmers who have access to oxen, they really prefer the ripper, because it's just much faster. Now, this tool is the tool to use and being promoted in Zambia as the tool for conservation farming for those who have oxen. And we recommend do the ripping in dry soil. So just break the soil and don't smear it. As soon as you are going to use a tool, whether it's a ripper or a plow or a hand hoe in wet soil, you start smearing the soil, and then you get what they call plow pans, hard pans, and water cannot penetrate. You just want to break the soil open so that water can go in and you don't smear anything. If you do that, then you actually reduce the tillage. You just plant, or you just work the soil in lines, in planting furrows. So you reduce the tillage a lot. You conserve water in those furrows. And since you can do it already in the dry season, this work, you can just wait for the best rain to come, the first good planting rain, and then you plant immediately on that good rain, so your planting is on time. And this system with a ripper, fitting in a larger system of conservation farming, actually you have seen that using this system with a ripper is making conservation farming feasible. This is a picture of one of the farmers that we were working with in our tests. And the farmer's practice is plowing with the oxen, and of course growing a lot of maize every year. So that is then compared on the left of the picture with the conservation farming system, whereby the farmer has done the ripping with the oxen and has grown maize again, but intercropped with cowpea, and done that after actually a rotation with velvet bean. And the difference of the crop is quite clear. And this farmer is convinced, he or she's talking with people from Gard and other farmers who are visiting actually farmers from Botswana visiting the farmer here. Here you see a detail of that same farmland with maize and cowpea intercropped. And you see there's very little weeds growing, because the cowpea actually is is competing with the wheat, and the maize is also competing very well with the maize, with the wheat. This is the Mogoi Ripper, but you see bigger wings on the ripper. An idea from the Tanzanian farmers who are using the ripper and actually said, we are so concerned about our weeding and we want to do it with a tool, with the same ripper. If the wings are bigger, we can push the soil aside into the crop rows. So it's a good weeding tool. So we have adapted the ripper for them. And I believe they're still using this. In Zambia, we are more promoting the conservation farming way of weeding, whereby we use preferably cover crops and, where necessary, also herbicides with glyphosate. Another adaptation of the Mogoi Ripper is from Namibia, where they were concerned for, in dry conditions, planting millet. So they developed a millet planter behind the Mogoi Ripper. And yes, you can see also there they put big wings, even bigger ones, and more horizontal wings. So to push soil aside to make broad furrows in which the millet is planted, so water is captured in those furrows. They are like small catchment areas, which then provides more water to the millet. So this Mogoi Ripper, we saw it being a good tool for introduction into the conservation farming system. Labor-wise, it was acceptable. It took some time to that you get out also. Labor-wise, it was a very acceptable tool by farmers. We have seen they can start conservation farming by ripping. But now the requirement of working dry soil can be very hard sometimes, and the ripper can do it, but it's sometimes a heavy job for some rippers if they're not keeping the tine very sharp. So we thought we should actually do something about it, just to reduce the draft force. And sometimes also the oxen are not so strong. So there was a need in the conservation farming promotion to have rippers which have less draft force requirement. This is the version that we then came up with. You can call it the Mogoi Ripper 2.0. The same idea, still also the wings, although not visible on the tool, but you can still fit those wings if you need. But really, ripping you can better do it without the wings on, so you can even go deeper with less draft force. The tine is narrower, and you also see that the tine has no bolts or nuts to fix it to the frame. It's just a pin which goes into a small pipe, which is welded on the frame. So it's easy to loosen the tine without tools, or maybe with a stone or a hammer, smash it off if you need to replace it and put a new one. The tine is also much smaller, so easier to penetrate in the soil, but otherwise the system is the same. So it's a tool which is really meant for breaking soil and the conditions which are quite hard. And then you can really go for better water harvesting in the furrows. We go back to Ethiopia. Farmers actually observed one thing for the Marecha plow. They have observed that it's not going very deep. So they actually are asking for a way to have a deeper tillage, so to store more moisture in the soil. And perhaps the Mogoi Ripper could be an idea for them as well. But now we go to Burkina, where the request for ripping was made to mechanize the zaai. And we suggested, let's try the Mogoi Ripper. And farmers have done the trials. They were quite enthusiastic about it, really. It was an encouraging start, but we saw that the Mogoi Ripper needed some adjustments because of the frame is different in Burkina than in Zambia, and also the request was made for even making it a lighter tool because of the donkeys needing to be able to pull as well. Many farmers are using donkeys for traction in Burkina Faso. So we have adjusted the tine angle so that it fits nicely on the frame in Burkina under the right angle. We made it a bit smaller and lighter. The tine is even smaller than on the Magoya version 2 ripper. And we call it the Kapandula ripper, meaning it rips, it breaks the soil in Tonga, the language of the area where the Magoya ripper was developed. Okay, the Kapandula ripper, you see here the detail of how it breaks the soil. Not smearing, it's dry soil and it's just cracking it and quite deep. And that makes a good furrow for water penetration once it starts raining. And another detail here is, of course, there's a lot of stover lying around on the land, and it should not block when you work in the field with a tool. And actually doesn't with this tool. The stalks of the maize are just sliding by and they're not blocking the tool. Of course, there should not be too much of the stover, but normally farmers allow cattle to graze and the stalks reduce a lot in number. And once you start ripping again for the next season, it's like this situation whereby the stalks are few but they don't block. So this is the team in Magoy who were involved in the testing of the Magoy ripper, the Kapandula, and they thank you for listening and for watching, and they hope that the tool, the Kapandula, is going to be an excellent tool for Burkina farmers as well.